And welcome everyone, my name is Pete. This is my channel, and that channel would be Rugged Outdoors Guide here on YouTube. Also, you can find us at ruggedoutdoorsguide.com on just a Google search. Check out our blog. We are all about everything outdoors. Well, okay, not everything outdoors. We're kind of about the things that you enjoy doing with your family, mostly, like fishing and camping and canoeing. Things that connect you to your loved ones. That's really what we're all about. And hopefully, we can even connect you with God. Now, this is not a religious station here. I'm not all about theology and preaching to you, although that's where my heart really is. Love canoeing, love the outdoors, but it's really not just about dropping a line in the water and catching a bass. Although that's pretty cool. We're all about that too. But we want you to connect with your family and to those who are important to you. So guys, what we are talking about today is developing some of those skills that will help you do that. And today we're talking about seating positions or sitting positions while you're paddling. Now, you've probably thought about paddle strokes, which ones to use, and you've thought about different paddles and canoes, and we have videos about all of those things. Please do check those out. But today we're talking about something that almost nobody talks about, and that is how to sit. Or maybe you're not sitting at all. What are you doing? Different positions will help alleviate different issues, like maybe sore knees or cramped legs or maybe a sore butt. We can help you with those issues. Stick around, I'll tell you what those positions are and which ones you should use and when. All right, is everybody there? Good, glad you're watching. All right, let's get into it right now. Seating positions, number one, actually sitting. But not just sitting, there's different ways you can sit. You can sit with your legs straight out. And this is probably the scenario that's best for your circulation in your legs. And so there it is there. Some canoes have a brace for your feet. This one does not, but that works well. The other scenario is that you can bring in your feet kind of like this under your seat, and that also alleviates some pressure. The only thing I'll say about this position is that it's common, but if you have your feet out like this, you're probably using your ab muscles more than anything else. You'll feel yourself using your ab muscles, which is not a bad thing. All right, so just a little something to keep in mind when you are in the sitting position with your legs straight out. Okay, next position is kneeling, kind of like this. It's a bit of a crouch, and your butt is against the seat, one of the seats. Now, I'm sitting facing what would be the stern on if I was canoeing tandem. So it's pretty wide here. I'm on the bow seat turned around because I have a symmetrical canoe. So that works. But if you were sitting in a narrower section, it would be easy to put your knees against the sides for more of a sturdy brace. But otherwise, it's still pretty sturdy. This is a good position for long distance cruising until, you know, your knees start to hurt. It's also really good. It's probably the most common position for running whitewater rapids, all right? Because you can be really, really sturdy using your knees as a brace. The thing to consider when you're in this position kneeling is that it might be helpful to have something to protect your knees if you're in it for the long haul. So you can wear knee pads, although that's really awkward. I don't see too many canoeists other than maybe some whitewater guys wearing knee pads while they're canoeing. But what you can get is pads for the bottom of your canoe right where you're kneeling, and that just makes it much, much easier. All right, so another position is actually still kneeling, but it's, you kind of go down like this and you sit on your heels. Now, the only problem with this one is that your legs can start to cramp up fairly quickly. And the idea is that you kneel kind of towards one side and the boat kind of tips a little bit. And then you can really do a lot of turns, and you just have a lot of control over just the direction of the canoe. This is kind of the classic Bill Mason, Becky Mason canoeing position. They go way over I've got a really light unloaded canoe now, and I'm not a super duper playboat kind of guy, and my legs cramp up quickly, so I don't really like that position. But it is what you do if you want to do a lot of just cuts and turns and moves. It's the classic look that you see some paddlers early in the morning, mist, and they're just twirling around in the lake. All right, so it is another good one. Bill Mason loves that position, kneeling with your butt on your heels. Okay, so the next position we're going to talk about is kneeling, but it's called a high kneel. So it's like this. And the idea behind this is that it really is probably the easiest on your joints in terms of blood circulation. Your knees are not bent very much. It's kind of a 90 degree bend. And it also allows you to get up really high, and you can see over top of your partner in front of you. For whatever reason, you might want to see over top of his or her head. But in any case, it just gives you a higher vantage point, and it can relax your butt if you need circulation going on there, if you've been sitting for a while, or if you're getting cramped knees from a kind of a crouchy kneel. That's the high kneel position. All right, so the next position is seated again, but it is paddle side leg extended with the other leg kind of just tucked underneath you like this. This is preferred by some whitewater paddlers. It is just another one in the arsenal of options that you have. I probably wouldn't do this long term, and because you have your paddle leg extended, it's not the most powerful. All right, that's the paddle leg extended position. All right, so the next position is the racing position. This position is absolutely the fastest, most powerful position. And this is a high kneel, except you're not kneeling with both knees. You're kneeling with the paddle side knee down, and the other leg is like this. It's just bent at about a 90 degree angle, your knee, and it gives you more power. Now, this one's a little bit tough to do like I am right now solo, because you got to kind of get way over to the edge and you got to tip over because you're standing up pretty tall. But normally when you're, well, I shouldn't say normally, this is solo racing as well. You just got to know what you're doing in the canoe so that you aren't too unstable, sitting up high and paddling really strong strokes. So anyways, this is the racing position, and it's definitely not something you use for cruising. It's just if you want to get from here to there really fast, or you actually are racing. All right, guys, we got one more position I want to talk about, and that is basically sitting. I've left it for last because it's the one I use the most. And you're sitting, except on your paddle side, your knee is bent, and on your non-paddle side, your leg is extended to whatever degree is comfortable for you. Your knee on the paddle side is touching kind of right where the side of the canoe hits the bottom of the canoe, and your leg is kind of on a 45, the lower leg is on a 45 degree angle underneath your seat. And this position is similar to the racing kneel, the racing position, except that it's your butt is kind of on the seat, so it's more comfortable and more sustainable than doing a high kneel, which is what the racing position is. So this one is really sustainable. There's no muscles really that are engaged in any major way other than the muscles you use in your arms and your shoulders for paddling. And it's the one that I want to say I use it probably 99% of the time. I don't know, I'm guessing, but I would say it's that. And it's good for both solo and tandem. All right, guys, so that's really my overview of some of the more common positions for canoeing. I certainly didn't touch on all of them. There are more of them. There's more different like variations on kneeling. There's a standing position. I'm not sure really why you'd want to do that, but sure, you can do that. There's lots of options, but those are some of the more common ones. I appreciate you guys sticking around watching me. I know there's about 75,000 channels, even just in the outdoor space, that you could have been watching instead of mine. It's probably more like 1.5 million or more. But anyway, thank you for sticking around for this one. And guys, if you appreciate what we do, we'd love to have a like and a subscribe. But even if you don't, I'm still gonna make videos every week that help you connect with your family And until I see you next time, guys, please remember, get out there, enjoy God's creation, and always remember, keep on looking up.